Hey everybody and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet the very pretty Trinity Stitch. If you love all things crochet and are passionate about the craft, then you have definitely come to the right place. Hit that subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss out on any of my future crochet videos. Now the Trinity Stitch is a very dense stitch. It has this very pretty, almost daisy star type pattern, but is perfect for dishcloths, baskets, bags, scarves, anything where you want a nice, dense, no holes fabric, this is the stitch for you. All right, let's leap straight into how you crochet the Trinity Stitch. So a quick tip before we start the Trinity Stitch. It is definitely one where you want to be crocheting a little bit more loosely than usually would. If you are a tight crocheter, I'd advise going up a hook size, maybe half a mil or a full millimeter larger than you'd normally use. But just bear that in mind, you want to be loose. Otherwise, you are creating problems for yourselves when you want to work back into the stitch. Okay, so the pattern multiple for the Trinity Stitch couldn't be simpler. It is two. That's all there is to it. So you want to go ahead and chain multiples of two for as wide as you want your project to be. So I've just chained 16 for my tiny little sample. And to start, you're going to skip this first chain and work into the second chain. Ignore this loop on your hook. It does not count as anything. So into this second chain from your hook, you're going to place a single crochet stitch. Now for the Trinity Stitch, you always start the stitch in the same chain that you just finished your last stitch in. Hopefully that makes sense. So we're going to be working immediately into the same chain where you placed your single crochet. So pop your hook into this chain where you just ended your stitch and pull up a loop. Now work into the next chain along, pull up a loop. And then one more time in the next chain, pull up a loop. So you'll have four loops on your hook worked over three chains. Then yarn over and pull through all four loops. Remember, keep things nice and loose. Then chain one. Now we're going to repeat this all the way down your chain. So starting in the chain where you just ended your stitch, pull up a loop. Pull up a loop in the next chain and the chain after that. Four loops on your hook worked over three chains. Yarn over and pull through all four loops. Chain one. Again, starting in that very last chain. Once you have four loops, yarn over, pull through all four, chain one. Keep those chain ones nice and loose as well. So always start your Trinity Stitch in the same place where you ended the last one. Once you have your four loops, yarn over, pull through all four loops, and chain one. Keep doing this for the full length of your chains. Once you reach the last three chains, complete a Trinity stitch just as before. So pull up a loop in those three chains. Yarn over and pull through all four, but do not chain one. At the start and end of the Trinity stitch, do not chain one. I can't stress that enough. If you chain one, you're going to throw out your count. So to end each row, do not chain one and instead put a single crochet in that very last chain where you just ended your Trinity stitch. The work into that same chain to end the row with a single crochet. So you start and end the row with a single crochet, no chain, and in the middle, Trinity stitch, chain one, Trinity stitch, chain one. So that's the tricky row out of the way. Now row two is the pattern row repeat. What that means is you will just simply repeat row two for as long as you want your project to be. So chain one and turn. Now to start, you're going to pop a single crochet into this very first stitch where you just chained from. Now we're going to begin the Trinity stitches again. So just as before, you start your stitch in the stitch where you just placed your last stitch. That's a lot of words. You want to pop it in where you have just worked your last stitch. So go back into that stitch and pull up a loop. Then you may find it easier to rotate the work towards you slightly so you can see your V's of the top of the stitch. We're going to work into this one here, go underneath both loops, pull up a loop, and then again into the next one, pull up a loop. Now, these can be a little bit tricky to get into, which is why you'll be glad you were hopefully working loosely on the row before. But once you have your four loops, yarn over, pull through all four, then chain one. Again, starting in that same stitch where you just ended, go back in, pull up a loop, into the next stitch, pull up a loop, and then into the next stitch. Now you may need to use your fingernail to help get into some of these. Once you have your four loops, yarn over, pull through, and chain one. So repeat this all the way across, pulling up three loops across three stitches. This little one is always a bit more difficult. Once you have your four loops, yarn over, pull through all four loops, and chain one. Always start your Trinity stitch in the same place where you just finished your previous one. Now, when you reach what you think may be the end, don't forget that you're on this very first row, your single crochet is tucked in and around here. So you do still have, you'll have two free stitches plus this one where you've ended. So there is still room for another Trinity stitch. This is the one that's very easy to miss right on this row too. So I'm going to chain one, and even though it only looks like I've got a couple of spaces, one, two, and then my single crochet is tucked just around the corner here. So don't forget to go into that one as well. So as it is my very last Trinity stitch of the row, I'm not going to chain one. Instead, I'm immediately going to put a single crochet back into that same stitch, the one you just ended on. So don't be thrown by that very last section. A way to double check, if I just pull my hook out a minute, is you want to have the same amount of Trinity Stitch clusters. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on each row. So if I flip this over, you can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on that base row too. So you simply want to repeat this second row for the full length of your project. So to start, chain one, turn your work and put a single crochet in that very first stitch. Do not chain one, but immediately work your Trinity stitch. Yarn over, pull through all four loops, and then chain one. Do this along the full width of your project. Then when you reach the end of your row, complete a Trinity stitch of those last three stitches. Don't forget this single crochet. This is the one it's easy to miss. Complete your Trinity stitch. Do not chain one and instead pop a single crochet back into that very same stitch. You'll see you have your seven clusters again. To identify those, you'll see these little three legs here. These three legs, that's your Trinity stitch cluster. So start and end the rows with a single crochet with no chain one, and in between, Trinity stitch, chain one. And just keep an eye that you have the same amount of Trinity stitch clusters for each row. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please do let me know what you think of the Trinity stitch down in the comments section below. Is it a stitch you'd be tempted to try, or is it indeed a stitch you've used before? And if so, what project did you use it on? I'd be fascinated to know. So until next time, happy crocheting!